Hello everyone, today this video is about a video demonstration of examination of the temporomandibular joint. So giving an intro for the temporomandibular joint, it is basically a ganglion arthrodal joint, very unique joint. It is the only joint which is present in the human skull which makes our mandible to move, and it helps in mastication and all those speech and everything is made possible because of this particular joint and the surrounding muscles, that is the muscles of mastication. So there can be many disorders and diseases which can affect this particular joint, and there may be a patient who can come to you with a complaint of pain or some issues with the joint. So for that, the examination of the temporomandibular joint is a very crucial topic which you have to know, which is the procedure which you have to know. It is very essential for that to come up to a diagnosis. So basically the examination of the temporomandibular joint involves three procedures. The first one is going to be the inspection. That is, you see you see from the front of the patient, you just see either it may be front or back, whichever it is, that I will be covering it in other few minutes of the video. And you just see and you evaluate, you look for any asymmetry, that is any both the sides, say they are similar or not, they are symmetrical or not, whether there is a swelling or whether there is any pus discharge from the joint, from the extra, when you see it from outside, or any deviation or deflection, anything is there that you see, or any erythema is present over that particular region before the ears. All those things you just you just examine with inspection, that is by seeing. Next is going to be the palpation. That is, you touch it, feel it, and you examine by then. By making that, you just examine the joint. And with this procedure of palpation, you can elicit about the any clicking sound is there, or any crepitations are there, and any deflection or deviation is there. All this can be found out with palpation. The third method is going to be by use of stethoscope. That is auscultation, where you keep the chest piece of the stethoscope over the temporomandibular joint area, and you just check for the crepitations or the clicking sounds. On talking about the techniques of palpation of a temporomandibular joint is concerned, there are two methods of palpation techniques. That is, one is going to be the intraauricular method, the other one is going to be the extraauricular method. So intraauricular method, it is done from the front of the patient, standing in front of the patient, and two fingers of the examiner is kept inside the ear hole of the patient. This is the patient's ear hole. So inside the ear hole, bilaterally, that is on both the sides, your single finger of an examiner is kept inside the hole of the patient, and patient is asked to open his mouth wide open. So in this regard, we can evaluate the posterior aspect of the temporomandibular joint in order to evaluate the deviation. So whether any deviation is there, whether any deflection is there, this can be ruled out with this method of palpation. So next, it is going to be the extraauricular method. In this extraauricular method, there is a landmark for this which has to be used. So that is going to be the tragus of the ear. So tragus of the ear is this projection which is present before the ear canal. This small projection, small soft tissue projection which is seen. And exactly 2.5 centimeters front to it, that is the point of palpation for an extraauricular technique. So here, so it is felt with the two fingers. And for this method of palpation, the examiner has to be from the back of the patient. From the back of the patient, that particular region, 2.5 centimeters front of the temporomandibular joint is palpated, and the patient is asked to open his mouth now. So in this regard, we can palpate the lateral aspect of the temporomandibular joint on both the sides. How to palpate for a deviation or deflection? How to elicit a response? Whether any deviation is there, any deflection is there. So deviation is that, so when the patient is opening his mouth, so as the patient is opening, it goes away from the midline on opening and goes back to the proper midline position. So this is called as deviation. Okay, and in this deviation, there can be two types of deviation, where it can be deviated to the same side
or it can be deviated to the opposite side. The side, when the deviation is present to the same side, it can be, the reasons can be any subcondylar fractures, any fracture beneath the like just below the condyle, or any hypoplasia of the condyle, etc. So, and also the internal derangement with reduction can be a reason when the deviation is towards the same side. Whereas when the deviation is towards the opposite side, then hyperplasia of the condyle can be considered. And the second type of the movement is deflection, where this deflection occurs in internal derangement without any reduction, where our patient opens the mouth. Once the patient opens the mouth, it goes to one particular side and stays in that side only, and it does not come back to the midline. Basically, deviation when it goes like this and comes to the normal position on opening, whereas deflection is when it goes away from the midline and stays in that position only. It's saying one cross, it goes to one side, one particular side. So this is going to be the difference between a deviation and deflection. So now we are going to see how to elicit this response on examination of a temporomandibular joint. When the patient is sitting in the complete supine position, then it is palpated exactly. This is the method of palpation is going to be the intra-auricular method, which I said, like the fingers has to be placed inside the ears and palpated. When the patient is in the supine position, then the examiner should stand behind the patient and elicit the response. Whereas when the patient is sitting in an upright position, just like this, then it should be elicited from the front of the patient, like this. So, yeah? Huh? Close? Yes. And in this regard, we can elicit the deflection or whether any deviation is there. This thing, what we are going to see is how to elicit any crepitation sound is there, or any tenderness is there, all those things. Basically, in this method of palpation, that is the extra auricular method we are going to use in this. And in this, at three positions we are going to check. The palpation is going to be done at three positions. First one is exactly on the extra auricular position, 2.5 centimeters front to the tragus of the ear. Bilaterally, it is palpated with two fingers. So here we are in the lateral aspect of the temporomandibular joint, and first with the mouth open, it is assessed whether any pain is there, everything is there, that can be seen and can be elicited. And then patient is asked to open the mouth up. So here again we can see any clicking sound is there on opening the mouth. This is the second position. And third position is we go little backwards and palpate the posterior aspect of the condyle. So these are the three positions where we have to palpate. And in this regard, any crepitations are there, any clicking sound is there, we can rule it out. So there are two basic differences between a crepitation or a clicking sound. So this clicking sound is a short sound, and it is also called as popping. Whereas crepitation is something like a continuous sound. It is a continuous graver-like sound, and it is like continuously heard. And it can be either, it can be done this crepitation or clicking sound can be elicited or can be heard by, generally by, normally we can hear, we can go closer to the patient and we can hear it, whether it is there on closing the mouth, it is there, or whether on opening the mouth, it is there. That has to be noted. And then also it can be done with the method of auscultation, so which is done with the help of the stethoscope, where the chest piece of the stethoscope is placed over the temporomandibular joint, and the patient is asked to open and close the mouth. So this can be significantly heard as compared to normal method with normal ears. That hearing with the normal ears, it will not be that significant, whereas hearing with the stethoscope is very significant, and it can be heard very easily. And next is going to be what you are going to see during a temporomandibular joint examination is that the mouth opening. So what is the range of movement of mouth opening? So first there are two variants, that is like interincisal, what is the maximum pain-free mouth opening. So this is like, once you ask the patient to open his mouth, how much till what distance he can open his mouth without having any pain in the temporomandibular joint. This is the maximum pain-free opening. And second one is going to be how much he can open to the maximum with pain, whether pain may be there or without pain. Pain may not be there. but patient is opening to his complete maximum, how much ever he can open. So this is going to be the maximum mouth opening with or without pain. So interincisional distance is measured with the help of a divider or a vernier caliper or a thread which can be all marked already, and then with that marking we can measure it, we can transfer it to a scale and we can measure it. So interincisional distance is measured generally from the incisal edge of upper teeth to the incisal edge of lower teeth. In the midline it is generally measured. So and once it is measured, what is done is the vertical overlap, and normally the upper teeth covers the lower teeth a little, which is called as the overbite, which is called. Also it can be a open bite where it doesn't overlap. So the formula goes like, to see the proper interincisal distance, you have to measure the interincisal distance between the upper incisor and the lower incisor, and then either add it up or minus it, subtract it from the overlap, the vertical overlap between the upper teeth and lower teeth. And there are also range of movements in a human's mouth. So what it can be done, there are three types of movements. So this maximum interincisal opening, it is greater than 40, or what we can say is like three finger mouth opening, where the three finger goes inside. So this is going to be the average normal mouth opening. And also there are some other movements which can be elicited, like which can be done by a human temporomandibular joint, that is the protrusive movement, where the patient can protrude his mandible towards the anterior portion. So this protrusive movement can be, this range can be greater than, the average is greater than 7 mm, whereas the patient can also put the mandible towards laterally, he can move it laterally also. This is called as the lateral movement, and this again the range of movement is greater than 7 mm. It is generally calculated between the midline of the upper two central incisors and also on the midline of the lower two central incisors. And next, moving on to the how to elicit whether there is any mouth restriction, on how to diagnose it, or how to elicit this thing, or how to infer if at all there is any mouth restriction, how to infer, and from that what diagnosis we can come up to. So in this we have to do an end field test. In this end field test, when the patient is not able to open his mouth, when there is a restricted mouth opening, so what is done, with the help of the fingers, a gentle movement is given on his lower teeth and asked him to, a little movement continues and the mandible continues to move little. So this is called as a soft end feel, where this soft end feel, so on application of a gentle pressure, the mandible moves to its maximum mouth opening. So this is called as soft end feel, and this can be attributed to, there may be some muscle issues, that is the muscles which are attached to the temporomandibular joint, there may be issues in that particular muscles. So because of that, this particular mouth restriction happens. And second is, when the patient is having a mouth restriction, restricted mouth opening, and even if we give pressure, a gentle pressure, the mandible does not move, and this response is called as a hardened feel. So in this, again, this may not be of a muscle origin, it is something, we can infer that it is something from the intra-articular origin, that is like inside the disc, the temporomandibular joint disc, there is some problem associated with the joint itself. So that is the reason we are getting this hard and feel response. So thank you everyone for watching this video.